हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 9 and 10 ऑफ क्लास 6 सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश 2, 9 चैप्टर टेंसेस एंड 10 चैप्टर ट्रांजिटिव एंड इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब. सो फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 9. वी नो दैट फाइनाइट वर्ब चेंज विद टेंसेस. लुक एट द टेबल बिलो टू हैव एन आइडिया ऑफ वेरियस टेंसेस एट अ ग्लांस. टेंसेस: प्रेजेंट टेंस, पास्ट टेंस, फ्यूचर टेंस. सिंपल प्रेजेंट: आई प्ले फुटबॉल. प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस: आई एम प्लेइंग फुटबॉल. Present perfect: I have played football. Present perfect continuous: I have been playing football. Past tense: simple past. I played football. Past continuous: I was playing football. Past perfect: I had played football. Past perfect continuous: I had been playing football. Future tense: simple future. I will be playing football. Future continuous: I will be playing football. Future perfect: I will have played football. Future perfect continuous: I will have been playing football. Simple present: we use the simple present tense for things that happen at a price. I go to a walk every morning. He usually reads till midnight. We often listen to the Kestis. For general truth: things that are always true. The earth moves around the sun. The sun shines during the day. Next: for things that stay the same for a long time. This watch keeps good time. They live in Chennai. Miss James teaches maths at Don Bosco School. Exercise 1. Complete the sentences using these verbs in the simple present tense. First one: the stars dash a night. Shine. S-H-I-N-E. Shine. Birds dash their wings. Birds fly with their wings. Fish dash in water. Live. L-I-V-E. Live. The plane dash at 6:15 a.m. Leaves. L-E-A-V-E-S. Leaves. Cows dash grass. Eat. E-A-T. Eat. Tom dash his homework regularly. Does. D-O-E-S. Does. Exercise 2. You are going to do the exercise 2. What do you do every day? Write 6 sentences in your notebook using the simple present tense. You may start like this: I get up at 6 a.m. every day. I had breakfast at 7:30, and so on. Next: present continuous. We use the present continuous tense to talk about things which are happening now. Anil is doing his homework now. Look, it is raining. We are playing tennis. The phone is ringing. Can you answer it? The present continuous is also used for the things that people have planned or arranged to do in the future. I am going to watch a movie tomorrow. We are going to Darjeeling next Sunday. They are having a party next week. Exercise 3. Complete the sentence using present continuous tense. Use the verb from the bracket. First one: Neeta dashed to Chennai this morning. Is traveling. Is TRAVELLING. Traveling. Second: I dash for lunch now. Will you join me? I'm going. Third: Dad can't come to the phone now. He dash a shower. Is taking. Fourth one: in this photograph we dash volleyball on the beach. Are playing. I can't play online games now. My brother dashed the computer to do this homework. Is using. Present perfect: we use the present perfect tense for action in the past when we are not thinking or talking about the exact time that they happen. Sentence in the present perfect tense connect the past and the present in some way. I have cleaned the bike. The bike is clean now. Somebody has broken the window. The window is broken, now broken. The school bus has come. It is now here. I have finished my homework. I am free now. Compare the above sentence with this: I finished my homework an hour ago. The simple past tense is used in this sentence because we have mentioned the time that the action happened. We can use the present perfect form of verb for actions or state which began in the past and are still going on. I have known him for a long time. We have lived in Delhi since 1945. The present perfect is often used with ever in question, never, yet, already, once, twice, three times, etc. Have you ever seen a gorilla? I have never visited the Taj Mahal. He hasn't come yet. I have already finished the work. I have been to America twice. Exercise 4. Complete the sentence using these verb in the present perfect tense. I dash the phone bill. Have paid. I dash the computer. You can use it. Have repaired. She dashed the dinner. Has cooked. It is very cold, so I dashed the window. Have closed. Oh dear, I dashed my finger. Have cut. We dashed in Hyderabad for over 10 years. Have lived. Present perfect continuous. We use the present perfect continuous tense to talk about action which begin at some time in the past and are still going on. This tense is often used with how long since and for. The children have been playing since 4:30. It has been raining for an hour. How long have you been waiting? She has been working in the school for about 6 years. For such actions, we can use the present perfect or the present perfect continuous with verb like work, live, stay, lie, etc. For example, there is almost no difference in meaning between the last sentence above and the following sentence. She had worked in the school for about 6 years. Exercise 5. Fill in the blanks with the verb in the boxes. Use the present perfect continuous. They dashed tennis since 4 o'clock. Have been playing. Have. Next. Sorry, I have written P here. It will come V. Have been playing. He dashed TV for an hour. Has been watching. Has been watching. Rupa and Rekha dashed to music since 9:30. Have been listening. Have been listening. He dashed the plant since 6 o'clock. Has been watering. Has been watering. I dashed French since last month. Have been learning. Have been learning. He dashed the gate for about 2 hours. Has been painting. Next, simple past. Read the sentences given in the two columns, present tense, past tense. Rama is present today. Rama was absent yesterday. It rains here every day. It rained hard last night. Kareem visits us daily. Kareem visits us last night. We use the simple past tense for an action completed at some time in the past. We talk or think about a definite time in the past. Example, yesterday at 7:30, last Monday, last month in 2003. I saw the movie last Sunday. Sachin scored a century in the last match. We visited Qutub Minar in 2002. I bought this camera in Bangalore. This tense is often used to tell a story. Exercise 6. Given below is the story of a thirsty crow. Fill in the blanks with the verb in the box. Use the simple past tense. A thirsty crow was flying around in search of water. It saw a pot near a house. There was some water at the bottom of the pot. The crow's beak did not reach the bottom. It picked up some small stones and dropped them one by one into the pot. Then the water rose and was near the top of the pot. The crow drank the water and flew away. Past continuous. We use the past continuous tense for an action which was in the middle of happening at the particular time in the past. What were you doing at 5:30 yesterday? I was playing chess. We were watching TV when Anil called. It was raining when I came out. As in the last two examples above, the past continuous often used with the simple past. It shows that the action was continuing at a time when a new shorter action happened. The simple past is used for the new action. Now, exercise 7, you are going to do by yourself, write what you are doing at the following hours last Sunday. You can use the hint here. Exercise 8. Use the verb in the bracket in simple past or past continuous to complete the sentences. You have to use both the tenses in the following sentence. The boy fall when he run. The boy fell when he was running. Okay. Next. I have a bath when the phone rang. I was having a bath when the phone rang. Next, Anita burned her hand while cooking. So how you are going to write? Anita burnt, B-U-R-N-T, burnt her hand while she was cooking. Okay. Usha dropped her purse while she get into the car. Dropped. She was getting. While I work in the garden, I hurt my back. While I was working in the garden, I hurt my back. Simple future. We use the simple future to talk about what we think or know will happen in the future. I will be 13 next Friday. I am sure that you will like him. Perhaps he will arrive in time for lunch. I think she will get the job. You will find a signpost at the end of the road. We also use the simple future when we decide to do something at the time of speaking. It is cold. I will shut the window. Okay, we will come tomorrow. The simple present tense and the present continuous tense are also used to talk about the future. We use the present continuous tense am is are plus going to plus base form to talk about things that we have already decided to do. Why are you filling the bucket with water? I am going to wash the car. We also use the present continuous tense when there is something in the present which tells us about the future. The clouds are very black. It is going to rain. Look out, the ladder is going to fall. We use the simple present when we talk about timetables. Tomorrow is Sunday. The plane departs at 7 p.m. Final exam starts next week. The concert begins at 6:30 p.m. The Monet exhibit closes on Sunday. The sale ends next week. What time does the movie start tonight? What time does the store open tomorrow? Exercise 9. The verb in the following sentences are in simple past tense. Change the sentences using the simple future tense and expressions like tomorrow, tonight, next week, etc. One has been done for you. First one, I met Mr. Pratap Singh yesterday. I will meet Mr. Pratap Singh tomorrow. Second, I cleaned the motorbike yesterday. So you are going to write, I will clean the motorbike tomorrow. I phoned Mr. Mehta last Sunday. I will phone Mr. Mehta next Sunday. I bought some CDs last week. I will buy some CDs next week. We played hockey yesterday afternoon. We will play hockey this afternoon. We were very busy yesterday evening. We will be very busy this evening. Exercise 10. You yourself are going to do. Look at the sentences you have written in the above exercise. Rewrite the sentences using going to in your notebook. Okay. Exercise 11. Fill in the above sentence with the correct form of verb. Choose from the bracket. I think Australia dash the match will win. Will win. What have you decided to do? I dash the club. Will join. At this time tomorrow, Mr. Kapoor dash to Malaysia. Will be flying. Mr. Raman is very busy at the moment. That's all right. I dash will wait. Why do you want to sell your motorbike? I dash a car. I am going to buy. With this, we have completed chapter number 9. Okay. Now, chapter number 10, transitive and intransitive verb. Read these sentences. The boy made a kite. The boy laughed. If I say to you, the boy made, I do not make complete sense. You want to know what the boy made. When I say the boy made a kite, I name the object which he made. The word kite is therefore called the object of the verb made. Definition: the verb made which requires an object to complete its sense is called a transitive verb. If I say the boy laughed, I make complete sense. You know what the boy did. He laughed. The verb by itself makes good sense. Such a verb as the verb laugh that does not require an object but makes good sense by itself is an intransitive verb. It will be seen there that transitive verb requires an object to complete the sense. Intransitive verb do not require any object to complete the sense. Transitive verb, intransitive verb. Karim opened the door. Some animals swim. Rama saw a snake. The poor woman swept. Use transitively, use intransitively. Many people eat rice. Wise people eat slowly. He writes novel, he writes legibly. Before you say whether a verb is transitive or intransitive, carefully examine how it is used. Exercise 1. Underline the verb in the following sentences and tell in each case whether the verb is transitive or intransitive. Where the verb is transitive, name the object. Okay, now. Rama loves verb, but Abdul hates it. Loves, it is transitive. Hates, also transitive. And verb is the object, it is the object. Some boys threw stones at the frog. Threw transitive stones the fire burned the house. Burnt, transitive. The house, object. Okay. The goat fell into the well. Fell, intransitive. I know a funny little man. No, transitive. Man. Okay. Next. Go and see your father tomorrow. Go see. Intransitive. Take your books and go home. Take, go. Intransitive. My new watch keeps good time. Keeps, transitive, object is the time. The clock stopped this morning. Stopped, intransitive. Mother Teresa won the Nobel Prize in 1979. Won, transitive. Nobel Prize, object. द क्रो सेट ऑन द ब्रांच एंड क्रॉड सेट क्रॉड इन ट्रांजिटिव द वीडियोड द फंक्शन दे वीडियोड द फंक्शन वीडियोड ट्रांजिटिव द फंक्शन ऑब्जेक्ट कंप्लीट द फॉलोइंग सेंटेंस विद एन ऑब्जेक्ट फर्स्ट वन द टीचर पनिश्ड द बॉयज माई ब्रदर रोट हिज पोयम द सन गिव्स लाइट द टेलर मेड द शर्ट द केक किल्ड द माउस A shoemaker makes shoes. He broke the glass. The mason built the building. The policeman catches the thief. The thief stole the bike. Direct and indirect object of a sentence. We have discussed object of the verb in the beginning of the chapter. There are two different types of object, direct objects and indirect objects. Read the given sentences. The dog chewed the slipper. He is playing the violin. Sana is visiting the grandparents. Did you complete your homework? In the above sentences, the word in italics are direct objects. Now read the sentences below. Sham sent his mother a brown package from Switzerland. Let us analyze the sentence. Sham is the subject and sent is the verb. To determine the direct object, ask yourself the question sent what? The answer is a brown package. Hence, the brown package is the direct object. To determine the indirect object, ask who received the direct object. The answer is his mother. Hence, his mother is an indirect object. Now read the sentences below. I brought bangles for my sister. I read the newspaper to my grandfather. We gave a map to the tourist. In the above sentences, the word in the italics are indirect object and the underlined words are indirect objects. Sorry, direct objects and the underlined words are indirect object. Exercise 3. In the following sentences, underline the direct object and circle the indirect object. My brother hit the ball with the racket. So, direct object we are going to underline. The ball and with the racket is the indirect object. We ran a ration shop. A ration shop is a direct object. My friend sold his car. His car, direct object. The singer sang a song for us. Song is a direct object and us is an indirect object. My mother swept the floor today morning. Floor is the direct object. The bear saw a man. Man is the direct object. The teacher taught the students computer. Students is the indirect object. Computer is the direct object. The shopkeeper kept the counter clean. Counter is the indirect object. So children, we have just completed chapter number 9 tenses. You have to complete your work on page number 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47 and chapter 10 page number 50 and 51 in your textbook. So complete your work in your textbook and notebook also. The exercises which I have given you. Thank you.